ganar, mamá, ganar.
Yeah, down with the EBT ghetto chef, Chef Bro ArDee, and we about to get busy up in this mug. Doing some international flavor.
I've noticed I do not support Kukuru whatsoever.
And guess who coming in through to the EBD ghetto chef, Chef Bro ArDee's kitchen? None other than his partner in crime, Tacos con Mucho Chile.
Thank you.
So, here we are, in the kitchen, in time for the big game, With Señor Tacos con Mucho Chile, he's going to cook in my kitchen, So, tell him, what are you cooking?
I'm cooking, by the way, this is Mohamed Martinez, tacos con mucho chile, and I'm going to cook empanadas argentinas rancheras. Now, the only place I can find empanadas argentinas, which are Argentine meat turnovers, and they're good. And the only place in East LA that I know, and they're making good. As a matter of fact, I got them fresh today at 4484 East Whittier Boulevard. It's called Sonora's Bakery, and they're the best. Now, why do I call it empanadas argentinas rancheras? Because the empanadas, the turnovers, are originally culturally from Argentina. But I put in the Mexican flavor that I came up with at work. I do my own cooking. So today, I'm gonna make it very simple for you. Anybody can do it. If you follow my instructions, you'll have no problem. It's very simple, and it's delicious too. Now, what I'm going to do, I cut as many stems as I can. And by the way, when you go buy broccoli, because all you need is this here, you don't need this. But to make it cheaper by the pound, when you go to the market, all you have to do, nobody's looking, throw this away. And then you get more for your bucks. Now, I will cut the stem on this one here. Stamp over here. I can use this one, right? I get action, so everybody jump with your rope. Looking like the way the sound pumping in your back pump. And let loose with the juice when I do rock. I'm too hot. Yeah. Say I got more juice than two pops. Yes, you don't need that much. All you need is empanada ranchera. And it's fresh. It came out of the oven this morning.
Ooh, looks like somebody's crack a butt. Yeah. Whose noggles is that?
Get your dirty hands out of my kitchen.
Oh, there he is. The Maldani. Oh my God, the Maldani. Ah! The Maldani. I tell you.
All you do is...
Don't cry for me, old Compton crew.
Cut the stems. The lesser stems you got, the better the food will taste. Now, what you do, cut it into pieces, surround it. Okay. The next step. I already cut some chopped mushrooms.
You're killing my people, man. You're killing my people.
Not just chingando,
cabrón. Hey, you're killing my people, man. The mushroom people. And if you meet the devil, yeah. That was with the mole people. The mole people were eating mushrooms.
Now, I left one uncut, so you can see. At all times, mushrooms, you cut it in the stem a little bit, because that's where the bacteria holds. Now, what you do, you cut. And then since it's a big one, you can make double. Like, see, voila. And then you can spread. All you need is two big mushrooms around it. One thing that I forgot to bring, I just noticed. Do you have any garlic?
Garlic? Here you go. Garlic.
Good. I found a treasure.
What skilled mastery.
See, on the garlic, you cut the end, the very tip on each side, like so. And then you peel it. You peel it, you take all the peel out. Very simple. Okay, once you peel it, you discard the rest. And the next step is very simple. Now, where is that big one? Oh, here it is. Okay. You mince it. Okay, yeah. You mince it. Now, it's important, the next ingredient, before you put the garlic, most of you have gone to Chinese restaurants, and on the table you'll see some dark soy sauce with chili. Okay, you mix it. It's important ingredient. One spoon. And all you do is go like this. Okay. And then you can put more if you want to. Just a little bit more. There you go. Just a little bit. Anyway, then once you put the oil in it, then you put the garlic so it can stick. That's the whole secret to it. You put the stick, there you go. Okay, now, the next step. Tomato sauce, canned tomato sauce. What you do, a little bit, spread it out real lightly. That's all you need. Now, it is important. You cover it. You put it in the microwave. We put it in for 6 minutes if it's fresh. Now, if it's frozen out of the freezer, you put it 7 minutes. Now, we have a push here.
The start button, where it says start.
There you go.
There you go.
You got it for 6 minutes?
Yep.
Okay. So, what we're gonna do, we're gonna cut off the air, and when it's ready, we'll come back on the air, and then we'll proceed. The next step.
Great deal of work and everything, but most importantly, you gotta keep your surface areas clean, and especially in this house, where the roaches will attack your food if you are not looking. They will drink your beer if you are not paying attention, and they will smoke your weed if you leave it alone long enough, such as the case may be. So let's clean this area up real quick in case we have another secondary charge of stuff here. We'll move all our implements out the way. We got to, because if we don't, the roaches will be sitting up here chip-chomping away on shit, man. I got enough problems trying to keep the motherfuckers out the sink. Shit. Damn. Trust me. No source material for the roaches.
Now, what do we do next is... Drain it. Now, usually I can drain it in the trash, but I'm gonna show you something. Okay. Sometimes you have some leftover juice on it. You pour it, and you can use that as gravy. You use that as a gravy element. For those of you who know how to make gravy, and it tastes good. Now, it was good. Now, the next step. A little more.
Wow, this actually looks better than that damn Compton coup.
Oh, you know about that Compton coup. Now, you put tapatio or any kind of sauce that you like. But I usually use tapatio. Okay. Now, next step. Your favorite sour cream. I already pre-stirred it, but when you get it out of the refrigerator, just stir it. And then, you already saw the tapatio, already put the tapatio. Again, according to your taste, and you put the sour cream. And one more item.
Dun, dun, dun. Dun, 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 dun.
Got this brand new. Haven't used it.
It's easy to get these at the 99-cent store if you are grazing.
Absolutely. Don't depend on the porn department. Get it by your hand. Okay. All you do is spread.
I see Mike. Oh, he ran up in there. Run, take your coup with you.
And now, guess what? Voila!
You have a 6 minute meal. A 6 minute meal? How much does this meal cost? In regular restaurants, it'll cost you 5 $39, plus tax and a 20% gratuity on the menu.
Actually, $125 for the empanada. I spent about maybe 20 cents on the mushrooms, 10 cents or 20 cents on the on the broccoli, the sour cream, you can get it for the 99 cent store, and so are the chips. The sour cream and the chips, they'll last
you
a long
you
time.
You got roaches crawling all up in this mug, right?
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. Yeah.
Mmm, tastes good.
We eat where the roaches are. Because we in the ghetto, baby.
Mmm.
And the whole meal will probably cost you no more than $1.68 to make.
I would say $2.
$2? Another $2 meal, people. And so we'll have a calorie intake at the end of this whole thing.
It tastes so good. Try it sometime. Yeah. My brother Gretz over here, he's gonna have some. My brother over here, he's gonna have some. I brought plenty. So, this is what you call the barrio cooking. You got brother Chef for ArDee. And you got, I don't know. Ritz? Folks, if you want the recipe for this empanadas rancheras from East LA, go to our website, below the plate, and it will be there. And bon appetit.
Bon appetit.
Thank you.
Well, sure, if it's appetit don't mind, I like to do it without a rubber. Yeah. Da-da-dum, dump, dump. Another one bites the dust.
That's all, folks. I wake up show rapping with Sway and Tech. My tech's like tech in the industry weapon. I'm Gino X, bring KRS in. One coming with the tech and sweat. Yo, I rock up on the littlest set and up on the biggest set. As ill as it gets, I still manage to wiggle your neck with sweat. Never forget, the bigger the budget, the bigger the debt. You gotta be willing to rock in the middle of drying, in the middle of wet. But I'm willing to bet on a sway and a tech, they stay in effect. Never been a pain in the neck, they gain the respect. Nevertheless, I'll wreck you. Now you know what sway and tech do. I'll be back, but for now, just sackle. Fresh. For $19.99, you sucker!
That's the way it was, y'all. Do you know 20 years ago, the Sugar Hill Gang was out, and we still don't get no respect?